Warning.
Wait, mate, will you shut your fucking noise? Don't watch if easily offended. Because I am going to rip the piss. Hi, it's Tommy. Gotta love me.
Marcus Rashford! 2-1 England! Atonement!
Kyle Walker has robbed it. How's the cross? Oh, it's brilliant! And Harry Kane's put it in! Captain Kane in stoppage time sends England to Russia. And there's the full-time whistle. England through with a game to spare.
Goal for England! Get in there, my sons. Hi, everybody, it's Tom, and I am jumping on the bandwagon for England in 2018 on the World Cup of Russia. Don't think I'm going to be left out on this bullshit, because it's hardcore, and I am humped and pumped for this World Cup. Believe me, people. Well, we're going to start with today, which are my addictions on the games. So I'm going to start with Group A, and we're going to do the little list of what I think will be a win or a loss or a draw, and what teams are total shit and what teams I'm pumped for. Group A. I'm going to say, I think Russia are going to sneak a win on the first one. I think they will, because they're the hosts. I think they're going to be lucky and they're going to stink a 1-0 win. But you heard it here from me first, people. You know what I'm saying? And the second game, I think, will be, I don't know, I'm going to stick my neck out. I'm going to say 1-0 win for Egypt. If not, it'd be a draw. I mean, I don't really give a shit about those two teams anyway, so I couldn't care who wins or loses, always. So let's get on to Group B. The top one of that group, it will definitely be the two front ones, so it's going to be a toughie. I'm going to stick my neck out and I'm going to say it's going to be a draw. It's either going to be a 1-1 draw or Spain will just nick a steal and they'll win it 2-1. Group C, people! And it's not a tough one for France. I'm not going to big France up because I can't stand fucking France. I mean, Arsenal got rid of Arsene Wenger. That's one Frenchie out the fucking door, so I couldn't care less. But I will say it, France will probably win this game, and they're going to win it probably, they're probably going to do it 3-0 or 3-1. Because the Aussies ain't quite there yet, are they? You know what I mean? Group D, people! And the D doesn't start for dick. Even though I may be acting like a total dick. We all know Argentina are going to smash the shit out of them, so I'm going to stick my neck out and say Argentina probably 3-0. Because my boy Messi, who Arsenal better be getting pen to paper and signing very soon. You know what I'm saying, people? Now we're going to talk about Group E. We all know who's going to win the top and who's going to be favourite in that group is going to be Brazil. Even though lately, the last couple of years, they have kind of gone downhill and they've been kind of shitty, but I don't know, they're a team you never want to play. You know what I mean? It's like playing against Spurs, you never want to play them, but they're always there, you know what I mean? Same with Chelsea, so Brazil, they're definitely on the undercard, you know what I mean? I mean, they could run away with this World Cup if people aren't on their toes in this game. The one and only fucking Group F. And that wall is being fucking built, Mexico. I'm gonna stick my neck out and I'm gonna say Sweden are gonna win that game with ease. They could sneak it 3-0, they're definitely gonna do 2-0. And with Germany and Mexico, there's no competition there. I mean, we all know Mexicans are dirty fuckers, but so are the Germans, I might add. But I do think they're still there. The Germans are gonna nick that one, they're gonna beat them probably 4-1, 4-2. But people, now we're getting to the heart of the group now, to the only team that fucking matters in my point of view. You know what I mean? The one and only England. Group G, the one and only. England, yeah, fucking get in there, my son. England! The one with the best team in it, people. Well, there's no competition here. England are going to fucking whitewash it. And Danny Welbeck is going to be the main player for England. Because the rest of the team's all made up of fucking Spurs players, so we took a chance there. I mean, I'm not going to say this England team's totally solid, but my heart is for England, and it always will be, so I've got to go with what we've got. And I'm just praying that Danny Welbeck can score, and the Tottenham strikers that he went with better do their job. Right, people, my addictions for the final of the World Cup to win. It's a toughie, man. I mean, if England get to the last 16, which I pray they do and I hope... I mean, I want England to do it, but I just don't think they're strong enough to do it, to tell you the truth. Hang on, heart. It's horrible to say it, but... I mean, my heart will always be for England number one. If they can do it, I mean, I'd love to see them win the World Cup more than anything in this world, but I just don't think they're going to do it. Not this year, not with the team they've got. So my addiction will be the final is going to be between Germany and probably France, because France have got such a solid team. Horrible feeling it's going to be Germany or France in the final. That's going to be my addiction. That's if England can't get there. I mean, if not, it'd be Germany-England, which that would be the final everyone in the world would like to see. Oh my days, that would be the World Cup of dreams. And Danny Welbeck scores the winning goals. I mean, oh my days, I'd be so happy, you know what I mean? Okay, so that's Tommy coming at you on my addiction for the World Cup. So people, please be nice to each other. Peace.